Greetings, minions! I am your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and I'm just here with a bit of an old imperious impressions. This time it's of Warhammer 40k. You know, I've just fucking realized I don't actually know what this game's called. Hang on a minute. Okay, shit, that doesn't help. Shit, sorry, you can't see it. I'm looking at the Mechanicus. There we go. So I'm looking at my Steam overlay there to try, but I had to go into the achievements to figure it out. I couldn't remember if it was Mechanicus or Mechanicum, because both are technically the Adeptus Mechanicus, because you know it's the Adeptus Mechanicus, or sometimes referred to as the Mechanicum, so it's hard to tell. Anyway, yes, Warhammer 40k Mechanicus, published by some dudes and developed by some guys. I didn't check. This is a bit of an ad hoc Imperious Impressions. I'm going to ask you to bear with me. I think this is the first Imperious Impressions I've actually done in a little while. I'm a bit out of practice. If you don't know what Warhammer 40k Mechanicus is, it is a turn-based tactics strategy squad XCOM-ish style thing set in the Warhammer 40k universe. It's something which I must say I was very excited for. I was really excited for it because the Mechanicus is a faction that I really don't think gets enough love in adaptations of Warhammer 40k, and also, they happen to be my favourite faction. They're generally my favourite part of Warhammer 40k. I'm a huge fan of the Mechanicus. Whenever I get the chance, I play a Tech Priest. Indeed, one of my favourite all-time RPG characters, you know, tabletop role-playing game characters, was a Heretic, a Loyalist Heretic in the service of the of the Inquisition in the game Dark Heresy. He was a loyalist heretic, and heretic is tech heretic. It's different from a heretic. It's a heretic by the standards of the Mechanicum, but not necessarily a heretic by the standards of the rest of Imperial society. So it takes the name Heretic. It's a great game. Fucking love that shit. I figured out how to do a pretty convincing tech priest voice effect, actually, due to that, because of reasons. But yes, this game. I was kind of wary of it, I'm not going to lie. I was excited, but I was also wary because I had no idea who the guys were who were developing it, and the art style of it was a bit, well, not the art style, but the graphical fidelity of it was quite low. And we've had a few pretty bad, pretty dodgy Warhammer Fantasy and 40k games recently. We've had a couple of great ones, but, you know, we've also had a bit of bullshit. Bit of a spoiler for the end of this episode. I really like this game, and I encourage you to pick it up. It's really good. I really enjoy it, and I have no need. And I'm not even saying that just because I got it for free, because I didn't this time. This is one of those rare occasions where I actually do an Imperious Impressions of a game I had to buy with my own money, because the devs didn't fucking get back to me. You rude cut. Nah, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. I mean, they didn't, but I'm kidding. I'm not that. I'm not mad about it. It's fine. I'm amazed that people do get back to me, if I'm honest. I'm amazed the fucking Stellaris devs still talk to me. Jesus fucking Christ. Yeah. So we're just gonna kind of, ideally what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you a couple of things here, and then we're gonna go through a mission. So, you can see here, this is kind of your main hub area. I say it's a bit XCOM-y. It's XCOM-y in that this screen actually implies it's more XCOM-y than it is, because it's got a tech thing here, which seems to imply that there's actually a tech tree. As far as I can tell, there isn't actually a tree. There's just some tech. And over here we have the cohort, which is our actual squad thing. Really, the only thing you're really doing in terms of customization, in terms of management, is literally entirely just managing your cohort. As far as I can tell, there's nothing beyond that. Over here, we've got kind of the list of tech priests in charge of the mission to this world. It's a tomb world, by all accounts, dealing with a Necron threat. With all, you know, varying different personalities. This guy is in charge. I think his name's Fastudius or something like that. I can't remember any of their names, really. I remember their personalities and their jobs, but not their names. This guy, as far as I can tell, doesn't actually give you missions. That guy, he's kind of representative as who we are. I think, like, it's strange, because it's implied that he's directly controlling the tech priests, but at the same time, we can make decisions that he doesn't like, and I don't understand how. I don't know, it's a bit confused. Then over here we got one mission giver here. It's kind of a tech-obsessed borderline heretic, just wants to study the Xenos tech and the Archaeotech and understand everything. Over here we've got a priestly type who wants to destroy anything that could possibly corrupt us, which basically means, well, everything. Down here we've got the leader of the Sectarii forces, who are the mechanical, not quite tech priests, but the kind of, not quite elite, but you know, the standard foot soldiers of the Adeptus Mechanicus. And these two, I don't quite know what they do, I'm not gonna lie. I assume one of them's a Magos biologist. I don't know what the other one is. I think this one's a Magos biologist, I don't know. Before we actually even have a look at these missions, let's have a look at what else we got here. You only really have, in terms of character customization, in terms of management, you've only got the one resource, that's Blackstone. Blackstone acting as both your currency and your experience, because you just spend it to do basically anything in the game. And it is quite easy to obtain so far, although I am fairly early on in, as you can see up here. So far, every mission I've taken, I've gotten a good chunk, so I've been able to at least spend, you know, get one or two level ups into my various cohort here. Over here we've got the Necron Awakening progress, where I believe that when this hits 100% the game's over. And this is kind of a bit of a timer that both kind of limits the amount of missions you can do and also kind of puts a risk reward thing on the amount of kind of tangents you go on while exploring the tombs, because the longer you spend in any tomb, and even the longer you spend in the actual fights, the higher that mission's Necron Awakening counter gets, and that actually gives buffs to the enemy, the higher that gets. And then when you get to the end of the mission, whatever number that reached is added in points percentage to the Necron Awakening amount. And yes, I believe when that hits full, I believe that's the end of the game. Talking about the tech tree, yeah, as I said, it's really not a tech tree. It's very much a list of things that you can get. That you just have to unlock by getting them as mission rewards, really. You know, which includes, you know, you got our weapons here. You got our support items here. Oh, and down here we actually have troops, which is an interesting thing. You deploy two kinds of unit. You deploy tech priests and you deploy troops. Tech priests can be leveled up and are important and will be permanently lost should they die. They are, as it were, your proper characters. The troops, however, are essentially expendable. You pay a cost to deploy them in the case of anything beyond the level 1 servitor. But they can just be basically frittered away. They don't level up. They are just, they're static. It's an interesting little thing, and I get a lot of use out of the troops, especially Skitarii, of course. There's Skitarii Ranger that I don't have in this go, because it's actually my second attempt at a campaign, because I was still learning it the first time. But yeah, so yeah, there's no tech tree. It's literally just a board of things. It's letting you know what you've unlocked, essentially, in a nice, easy way here. Also, I quite like how it does actually let you have a little preview of what it looks like here. Okay, let's also have a look at our cohort here. So far, as I said, we're quite early on, so we do only have the three tech priests, and of course, Skitarii Vanguard Alpha and the Servitor here. Adept Karth, not a reference to anything. Adept White, the name of that Heretic character I played that I mentioned earlier. And Magus Minarius is just the name of the automatically generated name. I will say this, actually, this annoys me. The fact that these tech priests are called Magos kind of bothers me. Because a Magos is specifically someone who's in charge of in tech priest society, as it were. These guys would all be Magoses. Because Magoses are, like, in charge of expeditions or planets. They're, like, important. These guys would be Adepts, which is why I've largely changed their names to Adept. And also, yeah, you can see down here, they're wearing black and red robes. That's because I'm an edgy little fucker, and because you can, quite pleasingly, I didn't know this was a thing, you can actually customize their colors. And I've gone to my custom one. You do, of course, also have the standard tech priests of Mars there, but I prefer my nice custom red and black there. Just, you know, makes it a bit different, makes it feel a bit like mine. Also, lovely art for these guys, lovely art. But yeah, I will say this is actually genuinely, even though, you know, technically the graphics aren't particularly impressive in this game, everything's a bit blocky, the texture resolution isn't fantastic, there's not all that much detail. I will say that I am absolutely in love with the simple fact that this game has done something, which if it hadn't done, I would have genuinely considered it a travesty, and that is, it visually represents everything you put on your character, which everything you put on your tech priests, which allows them to become very strange looking. And as you go down the classes, as it were, or the disciplines, you get various discipline specific augments that you can attach to various parts of your character's body, making them look more in line with that appearance. Adept White here is a Lex Mechanic. Which means he's just basically very good at getting cognition points. That's really all he does. But I kind of, you know, have equipped him pretty generically. You know, he's got a macro stubber there to do some physical damage, because a lot of shit has energy shielding. And he's got a big power axe there, because, you know, melee's always great. Especially given that the main Necron enemy is the Necron Warrior, who doesn't actually have a melee attack. And getting into range, if you get one hit off, does a lot of damage. The Necron Warrior has to move away to attempt to do his ranged hit, and then attack of opportunity. It's pretty nice. Also got a little, hang on, where is it? Yeah, there we go. A Curatio Mechadendrite. There, a little bit of healing, and over there, an Infestus Mechadendrite. Another kind of melee solution there. All is well with Adept White. You can also notice, actually, that over there you see the cognition cost. I'll talk about cognition when we actually get into the game, but the cognition is a very important resource that's only present in the actual dungeons. It's not a consistent thing. It's I think it persists within the dungeons, but it doesn't persist outside of them. Moving on here, we've got Adept Karth, who is a explorator who is quite quick, gets bonus. It does a thing in melee range. And, increased machine spirit attacks. Basically, from what I can tell, the Explorator is quite quick, and, you can see the Explorator is quite clearly designed a little bit towards, towards improving a melee attack. In fact, actually, I believe that, there it is. The Explorator armor augment increases physical damage. Quite good. Again, see there? Macro stubber. Always nice to have a macro stubber. Fully equipped. And again, another Curatio Mechadendrite, because, you need to keep you guys alive. And now, actually, we're going to move on to my favourite one, because this is the most fucking weird-looking thing. I am so happy that this game has kind of lent into some of the really weird aspects of the Adeptus Mechanicus visually. This, as you can see there, this one is a Dominus, which is basically a, Yeah, you can see it's kind of a ranged thing, kind of give a lot of ranged buffs here. And you may notice here that, no melee weapon. However, you may notice here that I've got some pretty good ranged weapons. Again, we've got the macro stubber, just because the macro stubber is really good, and I've not seen any reason to use the standard pistol since I've got the macro stubber. But over here, we've also got the Phosphor Serpenta, which is very nice. Cost a bit of cognition, but does a lot of damage over range and reveals enemy statistics, which is an important thing that you will see in the game. That's actually quite an important thing with these servo skulls getting involved there. And yeah, of course, here we've got the Dominus leg augments, which look at them. Awful weird spider legs. I fucking love it. Shit like this is why I love the tech priests. Okay, that's enough wittering on, I think. Let's actually get ourselves into a mission, shall we, since we're about 13 minutes in. As you can see here, install some Vox casters. That would give us the Skitarii Vanguard, level 1. That's one option. It's easy. That'll have us fighting Flayed Ones, Canoptech, Anchorites, I think that's how it's pronounced, and Necron Warriors. We've also got some Videx from Kepra, leader of the Skitarii. We've got a unit of Skitarii escorting a topographical surveying device to become trapped in the tomb of a guy. Subdomina Kepra has requested a cohort reach the unit and save the Oculus Topographus, which will give us more cognition. Ooh, the Skitarii Ranger. We might end up doing this one. Just because, Skitarii Ranger, that's a melee troop, which would be quite useful. We got Ro here, radiation burned, damage sustained during the warp transit, forced Caestus Metallican to vent much of its, the Caestus, I assume that's our ship. Quartermaster Ro, he's the Quartermaster, okay. Acquiring a supply of isotope material from the tomb, which will give us, an expensive weapon in terms of cognition cost, and in terms of augment requirement. Fuck, that we kind of would have to build a tech priest around that. And it is normal, but it's only got those things, and they're relatively easy to fight. And the last option is the Scutari have located the Scophagus of the... Yeah, this is a boss, I believe. I'm not ready to fight a boss right now. Ooh, the eradication, right. That's another expensive one. You know, just... You know what? I don't know. You know what, actually, because I don't want to fight immortals, because I haven't fought immortals yet, I don't really know how to deal with them. I think we're going to do Videx's mission, our master's voice here, with Scutari Vanguard. Yeah, and get that energy enhanced. Actually, that might be useful. Yes, that might actually be useful. Increase all energy attacks, gain 2 attacks. Yes, that'd be quite useful. And that just gives us some more Blackstone and more Scutari. So, yeah, launch mission. And of course, we're going to bring all of our tech priests. I've never found any reason to not bring as many of your tech priests as you can. And then fill up the rest of the ranks with... You know what? This setup worked well for me. 2 Servitors and a Scutari Vanguard Alpha worked well for me. We also, of course, over down here we have the so-called Canticles, which are basically just castable buffs or healing or health powers we can just basically spew out. You can only use them once per mission, but they can be used by any of your tech priests, and they don't cost, I think, actually any of your troops. I believe you can cast... No, I know for a fact you can use Canticles when you're controlling a troop. As opposed to just a character. But they do various things. Yeah, this one maxes the machine speed of all weapons, the count of the craft, increase your physical damage, and the litany of life. Do I have... No, I don't. I'm gonna actually get rid of... Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of that one about machine spirit, because I never really have a problem with having enough machine spirit in this game. We're just going to get the blessings of the Omnisire, because, you know, it's always nice to have a bit of extra cognition, given that cognition is, it's essentially your command points in other games, but, you don't necessarily automatically generate it. That's another thing. This game has a very interesting approach. It doesn't have, aside from the opening of the game, like the very opening, as soon as you open the game, it goes into a bit of a cutscene with some establishing dialogue, which I believe is also the trailer for the game. The game lacks any kind of voice acting beyond the kind of almost, like, incredibly edgy Banjo-Kazooie bebop, job noises that the characters make. It sounds right, especially given that I'm pretty sure these guys are all supposed to be communicating via the noose sphere, which means they're speaking in binary, or whatever the hell the tech priest language is. I believe it's binary, that they're said to speak. But yeah, they are communicating in data with each other rather than actual words. So, makes sense. Also, just sounds good. It works. Yeah, Faustinus. I knew it was like Faustinius or something like that. Spreading the incense was not enough. You're not relevant to the Necron's overwhelming observations on the tech cosmos, verse 68. We are derelict in our duty whenever we allow corruption to plague the minds of good men. I especially like how he sounds. You know what? No, I just like all the generic kind of 40k metal ass fake voices. It all sounds good. This game does a remarkable job of capturing the kind of tone that the Mechanicus is supposed to hit. It's kind of a very peculiar combination of extreme fanaticism and, like, extreme religious fanaticism and dogmatism, as well as the kind of peculiar scientific obsession. It's very strange. I'm not going to read this out loud. You can read the Lecta Dogmatis. I love that as a title. You can read that if you want. It's not massively important. I mean, it kind of is, if you're following the story, but I have done this mission before. The voice can... Tomb of the Ring with the Omnisire's word. We'll just skip this. Let's skip that dialogue. If you want it, you can play it. Right, so this is... So now we're into the actual game. The game, yep, almost essentially entirely takes place in these relatively small-scale dungeons. They're essentially collections of rooms here. You see up here we've got the Tomb's Awakening level, which ticks over as we travel through, which go from room to room. That goes up. And of course, certain events within certain rooms can cause it to go up quicker, or can cause it to fall back down, depending on the outcome of your choices. You'll see what I mean just here, because the first room has an event. What do you have for us? One of the Vox casters, being transported by the cohort, begins emitting strains of music from an unknown source. The music sounds like it is of human origin, but it could interfere with the binary transmissions. Yeah, I thought they spoke to each other in binary. We can stifle it, we can seek the source, or we can shame. We can shame whoever's doing it. I do find that generally it's kind of difficult to figure out which one of these is supposed to do. It does appear very luck-based, because I assume one of these is correct. But it does seem like each of them just kind of have... It seems like the decision of which one's right is fairly arbitrary. Let's broadcast, and I tend to try to go with whatever I assume the person who gave me the mission would want me to do. And that seems to work more often than not, but I don't know if that's just me being lucky. And I assume that our Lector Dogmatus had wanted to shame them. Cool, we shouldn't have done that. Every member of mission personnel is informed that non-standard data is being transmitted by someone in the tomb of blah blah blah. Shortly afterwards, the music ceases, but the mass chastisement is damaging to morale. Yep, which gives the Necrons an initiative advantage in combat. It's a bit of a pisser because, yeah, they're there. Ah, well, we'll go straight into combat anyway. Here we go. Hopefully it'll be fine. Depending on the enemy layout, it won't even be a problem. This game, I will say, does take a little bit to figure out how it actually works, because the game seems to imply that it has, the game kind of implies that it's got a cover system, and it just really doesn't. At least I expected it to have a cover system, and it just doesn't. For what, you know, what may very well be fairly understandable reasons to most of you, because the game is, yeah, it's not XCOM, like, it just seems like it should be, but, so it took me a little bit to, as it were, adapt to the way the game requires you to play it in order to, actually get anywhere. And as you can see there, because of our bad choices earlier, the enemy gets to move away immediately. Thankfully, we've been a bit lucky here, because, yeah, cognition points. You can see here we can have a maximum of, I believe that's 5 there. Cognition points are required to do certain actions, such as use a melee weapon or indeed use Minarius's fancy gun, as well as certain healing items, certain support items you can unlock, certain weapon types, all sorts of nonsense. They're also required to sprint, as you can see there. Be spending spending something to move over there. However, there are multiple ways to gain cognition points. If you have a servitor and the servitor gets hurt, the servitor troop, any damage it takes produces a cognition. You can also get cognition through events, but in the battlefield, the main two ways you're going to be getting cognition is by interacting with these items here, kind of Necron obelisks, I suppose, that produce a certain amount of cognition. Generally, it's 1. Thankfully, we have Adept White here, because generally, you can always send, you can either move your guy in to touch it directly, or you can send a servo skull. Now, most of your tech priest's servo skulls will only collect 1 cognition maximum ever from anything. However, thankfully, we've got, I genuinely can't remember what kind of class he is, but this guy's class, Adept White's class here, allows his servo skull to collect all the cognition he wants. So, he's doing alright, isn't he? And of course, we're gonna just shift Adept White here and open fucking fire! And you may notice there that not only do we not get a projection of how much damage we're doing, we also... Yeah, we don't know. The game... Yeah, this is... Gonna be blunt with you. This is why you don't necessarily... want to be, yeah, it's why you don't necessarily, it's why the use of the servo skull to collect cognition points is a bit something to be a little bit wary of, because every enemy, does, you need to scan them somehow, essentially, in order to know what the hell you're doing with them. It's a sad truth, but there it is. Just pick that cognition up from that lad there, and then I think immediately put ourselves next to this thing, so it can't run away. And yep, no healing there, so that's his turn done. We're actually gonna delay his turn so we can get Our Lady moved in here. You may notice that Necron is on the ground, but not dead. It doesn't have a timer on it right now, but it will shortly. Very good reason for that. That's because the Necrons in this game, much like the Necrons in the lore, can get back up. Unless you execute them. Attacking them once they're down with an attack that does literally any kind of damage will do. Also, actually, if you kill them with a critical hit, it will kill them as well. I believe that once they've gotten up, I believe they can only get up the once. Once they've gotten up, if you kill them again, they are just gone. But yeah, they will get up there. You know what? Let's reveal some stats. Oh, you're kind of a little bit of a toughie, that one. I'm gonna stay there. Actually, I can't really think of a reason to move. Meanwhile, let's scuttle our guy with his incredibly strange legs over here. And first of all, let's get a macro. Actually, you know what? Yeah, that'll do. Blow that thing to buggery. Oh, did I destroy that? Cool. I believe I just got a crit. Or that might be one of the enemy types that doesn't actually, drop. I believe it's only, like, the humanoid Necrons. Or at least the... It sounds weird to say. But the, as it were, standard pattern Necrons that do that? Oh, amazing. Oh yeah, that's the thing. Our Dominus here, when he scans an enemy, it does damage. 1 point of damage, which was enough to knock that guy out of the fight. So now it's just that one unit. Assuming no more Necrons spawn. Sometimes Necrons do, but I think we did this fight early enough that no Necrons are actually going to spawn. Although, those Scarabs have spawned, which is a bit of an annoyance, but not a massive one. Here we've just been given the option, every turn, when a new round starts, you're given the option to spawn in some of your troops, anything you haven't spawned in already. It costs cognition, but at the minute, I don't think we need any. I think we're doing fine. Oh, good! Down you went. Really didn't go great for you, did it? And we are doing pretty damn good in terms of cognition here. Yeah, we got 3 turns, fuck it. Fire on that thing. Yeah, that'll do. Because frankly, that's another thing, if you're actually able to knock everything that can be knocked down and everything else is dead, it will actually just end the game, end the match, without you having to actually kill it. Which is always nice, I find. Let us fire the fancy gun! Yep, that's... fucking ruined that guy, isn't it? Let us fire the less fancy gun! And I think that should be... Yep, level done. And we absorbed what cognition was present in the level. No threats remaining. Fan-dabby-dozy. Just occurred to me this is going to be a slightly long episode, but then again, I haven't recorded anything like today because I've been re-downloading all my stuff to my new hard drive. So, yeah. Okay, all of our units healed for 2 HP. The Awakening's been reduced by 3, so actually that's knocked it back down to fuck all, and got some Blackstone. Sick. Though I did just realise we didn't scan. There was a terminal we could have scanned in there. There's sometimes terminals and levels in the combat levels that you in the combat arenas that you can scan. They'll give you some more Blackstone. Yeah, I just forgot to do that. Unfortunately, we didn't actually have any units that took. I don't think we took any damage in that fight at all because I've actually started figuring out how to fucking play this game. When I first played this, I was awful at it. I just couldn't work my head around it. Then again, it was 4 AM when I started playing it for the first time, so that'll probably be why. What have we got here? Cohort's communications, pick up a transmission played in a binary adjacent Xenos language that can be interpreted as a distress signal. Let us... approach. No, Xenos. I don't... Observe. I'm not getting involved. God damn it. I'm just making really bad choices here. Yeah, because I've just immediately fucking woken the Necrons back up, haven't I? Also, we have these rooms. Glyph rooms. Where basically you just need to make a choice between two symbols. Yeah, glyph. The panel shows a heavy door leading to a treasure room beyond which is filled with cognition. If we can work out the right commands, we can reap the rewards within. I've yet to figure out if there's actually any pattern here. Yeah, I've yet to figure it out. I assume there is a pattern that, like, certain glyphs are useful in certain circumstances where others aren't. Case in point, actually. I believe I've used this glyph in this one before, so occasionally you do get warned that it'll fuck you. So let's use that one. Okay, cool. So we still got fucked there, which is great. Oh, that's actually a thing. On a plus side, yeah, the awake level doesn't go up when you're traveling through old rooms. It only actually goes up or down when you interact with a new encounter, as far as I can tell. Oh, foul. Could this be a place of Xenos worship? We have no data on their religious practices. Who cares? Defile the altar. I've done this one before, and this turned out well, so let's see if it turns out well again. Situation, study, religious fervor, conclusion, disappointment. Logical choice, Magos. The Creed of Mars should be the only faith on Silver Tenebris. Videx and that other one, whose name I wasn't looking at, they argue a lot. Because obviously one's a research-obsessed nightmare and the other one's a religiously-obsessed nightmare, so of course they butt heads constantly. Oh, cool! We actually got a bit of tech there. Spotlight. Nice. Always nice to get new stuff. You know what? Let's go have a fight! I think we've got, is level 2 more Necron spawn? I think that's what level 2 is. Also, yep, give it a second. It freezes up occasionally. Extra Necrons in battle. Well, shouldn't be a problem. We managed to fight that last fight without taking any fucking damage, so... We'll be reet. It'll be a reet. Plus, I really need to get more fucking combat in this episode. I will say this, if you don't like Necrons and you don't like, if you don't like Necrons and you don't like Tech Priests, this game's not for you. Not good. Can't lie. This game's a bad'un if you don't like... If you don't like Necrons or Tech Priests, you're gonna have a bad time. You're gonna have a really bad time. Shit. Yeah, unfortunate spawning. We were just already in range of that guy. There was like a limit to what we could do. Thankfully, that dude, fucking miles away. Found Dabby Dozy. Right. I mean, I am doing this, but I also don't actually know where that's going. Ooh, yes we will. I will send dear old Adept White over here, because that is actually a pretty solid spot for him to be, actually, because then we can get that console over there. And there's a lot of cognition over there. And, beautifully, there's a 2 cognition down there, because we are definitely not going down there, but I will slurp up that cognition, Meowmucker. You have no idea how curious I am about whether or not I can push this guy off this edge. No, I can't. That plan was too beautiful for this world. That would have been fantastic if I just just kicked him off the edge. Hello, I'm a spider nightmare. Oh wait, hang on. Do I have a canticle for energy weapons? No, I don't. Oh well, worth a try. Fire the big gun. Cool, well, he's fucking dead. I mean, that solves one problem, I guess. Kill him immediately, don't worry about it. End the turn, and, you know, You know what? Yeah, I'm gonna send this tech priest without a point, actually, because the melee guys are useful. If push comes to shove, I can literally summon in melee to protect our other tech priest, our tech priest bud there. And yeah, to mess him up. Lovely. Lovely jubbly. Yeah, fuck it, end the turn. yes, move up here, you awful nightmarish flayed one.
Oh no, I've been shot at.
Thankfully, I've got a little bit of energy damage, energy shielding. Oh dear, the Necrons get back up a wee bit faster. Hopefully not too much faster. Okay, that's woken up. And yeah, we can actually just spawn in some guys. So, yeah, I'm gonna spawn in Skitari. Might as well. Especially because actually, if we can get him in range, that'd be, he's in quite a good spot to start a fight, not gonna lie. And yeah, let's rush him over there. Scan that for me, would you, mate? There we go. Lovely. Ah, I can't. Well, shit. Hi there. How's your father? Eat this. His father's fine. Yeah, might as well. I might as well. Get a bit of healing in him. Always nice to get a bit of healing in you. Ooh. That's a thing. Unfortunately, I currently... How much further do... Okay, cool. I'll just scuttle him there. Because unfortunately, I... Unless there's another thing that produces cognition. Oh, there you go. That produces cognition. That'll do. Now I can shoot you. Let's see what happens. You died. That's what happened. So we get to shoot you again. Again, this guy, like, so often, this one Magos one-shots people. It's like, it's pretty fantastic. And yeah, he's not going to be able to actually do any damage. Actually, can he do any damage? No, he can't. He's not going to do any damage this turn, but he will prove his worth next turn. You, stop that, yeah? There you go. And yeah, let's get you in range, and Bob's your uncle. Who do we want to reveal the stats of? Yeah, you're the one I'm gonna fight next. Gonna quietly clump his way over here. Meanwhile, that's just gonna rocket hither and thither. Yeah, we don't need any servitors. Although, yeah, that's Skitari. He's gonna just eat four damage in the. Okay, he's gonna eat three damage in the face. Same thing, more or less. Good night, sweet prince. He tried. That's the... he gave it a good college try. That's the important thing, I feel. That Necron did try. Are you awake? Yes, you are. Sorry, mate. Just need to quickly absorb some of the cognition you got there. Lovely. Eat power axe, you dickhead. Cool. Gonna delay that turn, literally just so I can actually, use the Skitari to do some damage. Why? Because I want to. Basically, it justifies presence. If I'm being honest, that's explicitly what I did that for. Justify the presence of the Skitari. Whack it with the power axe. Oh dear, it's not dead. Move back a bit. Shoot it. There we go, that did it. That did it fabulously. And, yeah, hopefully this'll just kill this thing. Oh god, it didn't quite kill it. This'll... Oh no, wait, hang on. Sorry, I need to scuttle forward a bit. Right. Yeah, this'll fucking kill it. And that should be... Yep, that's a level. No threats remaining. Because the Mechanicus is... Because the Mechanicus will never be defeated by this Xenos filth. Oh, and everyone got healed to 1 HP. Which I think, actually, yeah, that put Adept White back up to 4. There's the thing, actually, you do lose Blackstone if your Tech Priests come back. You lose a bit of it if your Tech Priests come back injured. So if you can, heal your guys up, if at all possible, before you end the dungeon. I've found. Right, let's actually do the fucking mission. Necron Tomb is trying to defend itself. Clear mission is working. Yep, enemy freaks out. Righteous application of flame. Let's burn away the scarabs. A sound strategy. Which worked, but it has, yeah, affected the awakening. Oh, we don't have to fight. I was really expecting to have to fight, though. Well, if we have to fight again, it's going to be over there. Just scuttle along here. This is a sort of thing that just slightly annoys me. The one with the weird spider legs. If you notice there, you can tilt one turn, but if you notice the little spider legs don't actually animate in this view for whatever reason. I suspect that's unintentional. Rightio, last room. And yep, Necrons. Yeah, this is gonna be like a fucking 40 minute or near an hour long episode, I reckon. And yep, the survive three rounds one. The survive three rounds. While everything spawns in, then kill everything. It's a slightly misleading name for a round, if you ask me. A slightly misleading instruction, I should say. Because it sounds like you're about to die. Yeah, that is a thing. These guys actually absorb cognition for whatever reason. Mildly irritating. Although currently it does actually look like, does currently look like these guys are the only thing that's actually in here. Well, yeah, I suppose that does make sense, because more enemies are going to spawn in as we go on. Just keep shooting him. There's literally no reason to waste cognition on this guy right now. Yeah, you scuttle over there, get your cognition. Get that cognition in your sack. Lovely. Let's rush our dear explorator over here. Get some pot shots fired off. It is slightly irritating when you don't know how much damage you're doing, I will admit that. And you know what? I'm not actually gonna fire at that thing. I'm gonna fire at this guy. Just so he doesn't get back up. Just cause I don't want him to. And yeah, I think guessing. Oh, we got a flayed one, and okay, I was just expecting the one Necron warrior. But we got a twofer. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna summon that Skitarii. Oh, and he's gonna waste his time getting a cognition. And then immediately getting killed. Okay. Fantastic first class. Oh, did I not summon in? Oh, I didn't fucking summon in the Skitarii. Well, I may have been an arsehole. You know what? Fuck it. Shoot that guy. He's arguably more of a problem right now, considering we have what I can only describe as two piles of melee over there. I think I. Oh, cool. Okay. I think I can. I think that'll actually. Yep, that actually killed him. What? I did not know you can actually do that with a Servo Skull. I don't know why I didn't know you couldn't do that with a servo. You could do that with a servo skull. For some reason, it had never occurred to me to try that with a servo skull. There we go. Increase that. And yeah, just do some physical damage. Wait, really? Really, you're dead. I mean, sure. I'll take it. Because now there's no enemies here until the next round. Oh. Okay, yeah, I know what we need to do now. We need to get over there to get that extra blackstone. Where's the enemy going to spawn from? This is the question. Oh, actually, the bigger question is, can I get Adept White over there? By just, like, kind of spending this excess cognition we have. You know what? I can in the next turn. Yeah, I'm not going to waste any more cognition doing that, but I can get in there next turn. Oop, up comes a flayed one. Oh, straight into an attack of opportunity range, though. I can't help but notice. And yeah, this is immediately into kill everything range. And you know what? Summon in a servitor there, and give him a good smack across the bonds! Okay, when I said a good smack across the bonds, I'm gonna be honest, I was deliberately overselling it. Conservators do basically nothing. They are literally meat shields. It's just explicitly what they're for. Shift him over here a bit. Yeah, get a shot off there. Might as well, since I'm stood here. Bit of extra damage there while I can. And get this scan done, even if it does cost me a bit of cognition. Well, cost me a bit of cognition to get there, but it's all worth it. Look at that. Our turn. And, yeah, hopefully this will do for him. Fantastic. One shot, one kill. Well, one shot, one down, immediately followed by the execution shot. Fucking fabulous. Gotta love it. And this should be. Yep. The end of the fight. Pretty good. Actually, I'll also get to show us leveling up the tech priests a little bit. Yep, Sang's the Archmage guy. Who cares? Oh, hello. Turn the volume to maximum. Yeah, fuck it. It will be exalted. Okay, turning the volume to maximum gave us even more Blackstone. Lovely. Last time that went very badly. Mission complete. I don't care about your plot. I mean, if you want the plot, which is interesting, but I have seen that plot before, buy the game yourselves. As I said, I do recommend it. You can see there, because everyone had full health, we get our Blackstone. We don't lose any Blackstone. I believe we actually get a refund of 6 Blackstone there from this guy. And yeah, as you can see here, we do get points. We get extra Blackstone for every enemy killed as well. So, and yep, the Blackstone from the direct reward unlocked a new kind of troop. And got that. That's been knocked up a little bit. There's some statistics. Close that, and ho Nelly, that's a lot of Blackstone. Oh, and I got an achievement, Radium Ready. I don't even know what that is. I genuinely don't know what Radium Ready is. Oh, unlock a Skitarii Vanguard. Okay, makes sense. There he is, lovely. Oh, good, he's got a rifle. That's actually quite nice, having a ranged... Oh, so we do now actually have a melee Skitarii and a ranged Skitarii. Lovely. Well, let's level these guys up a bit. I'm going to invest in our dear Dominus here, because he is very good. From the looks of it, we might. Energy enhancers. Oh, we literally just got that. Sick. Stick that on me back. Do I even have any energy weapons? Oh, yes I do. The Phosphor Serpenta is an energy weapon. All energy attacks go. Cool. That's actually quite useful. Sick. And let's upgrade him again. Let's get that that final unique body part, plus energy armor, increase maximum health. Glue that to him. There we go, lovely. That, and yeah, let's get him that final thing, the Rites of Rage. Of range, if no melee is weapon is equipped, gain plus one damage, plus one physical armor. Just a bunch of stuff that makes him better at firing from range. And I just unlocked achievement, knowledge is power. Yep, have a tech priest, fall in the discipline tree. I don't know if I can actually level this guy up anymore. I don't know if this is like the best he can get. Gillette, the best a man can get. Oh, wait, I can actually equip him with one more thing. The hell else can I equip him with? Genuinely don't know what else to give him. Because I can give him another support weapon. I can also give him a mechadendrite. I suppose, yeah, just for now, since I don't know what else to give him that mechadendrite. It's also 6, hopefully. Yep, I can also upgrade someone else. I can get scanners have a minus one cooldown. Are you a scanner? Is that what you are? I don't know. I don't know if that's actually... I don't know if he actually counts as a scanner. And, what do I get from you, Adept Karth? Oh, I can actually just get you a new bit of equipment. We will get... Yeah, sure. Yeah, we'll get that and we'll, stick that new chest piece on you there. Lovely. What a big tough boy. Okay. Okay, so that's just under an hour on Warhammer 40k Mechanicus. Really good. It's genuinely just a very good game. Yeah, I'm glad it's turned out as well as it has. I really am. Because I was worried it might be terrible. Because so excited for this, so excited to have a game where finally the Mechanicus is actually the, kind of the focal point. And I was worried they'd fuck it up. They didn't, because I didn't know who they were, and no one had ever heard of them as far as I could tell. And they didn't fuck it up. They made just a genuinely very, very fun, squad-based tactics game, playing as the Mechanicus. It's great, I wholeheartedly suggest it. There'll be a link to the Steam page in the description. But, that's gonna have to be all for me for now. I've been your Human Rage Uncle Sideways, and, well... Bye.
Is it done? Okay, cool. So I'm just gonna quickly tell you about some links in the description. Not gonna take up too much of your time because you've probably got other things to do and other videos to watch. So in the description there, you're gonna find a link to my Patreon if you want to support the channel, support me. Feel free to click that link and help me out down there. You'll also find a link to my Discord server where I talk a lot of bullshit and occasionally play games with folk. So maybe go down there, follow, join that Discord. Let's have a chat, you guys. Let's have a bit of an old chinwag. And you'll also find my Twitter where I occasionally post dumb things. I think that's about it. Yeah, so I'm gonna go away now. Bye.